Hello and welcome to another tutorial in monitoring of forest resources. My name is Lutz Fermann, and in this video I'm going to explain how you can convert your own thumb to a measurement device that you can use to predict the stand basal area. In the last video I showed you this very simple dendrometer that we use to create an opening angle, and that helps us to implement a Relascope plot or a Bitterlich plot. We can do nearly exactly the same thing also using our own thumb. And for this purpose I need to establish or determine the relation between the length of my arm or the distance of my thumb from my eye and the width of my thumb. This, however, is quite difficult to measure and not very precise. And that's why I use a different approach. As you can see, I have marked a medium tree there and I laid out a tape on the ground to determine my distance. I'm now using my thumb on my stretched out arm, and it's better to stretch your arm out to the side and not to the front, because this is not a very stable relation if you turn your shoulders. So stretch it to the side and find the position where your thumb exactly covers the width of this tree by moving forward and backward. For me, this position is exactly here. On the tape that I laid out, I can determine the distance, and here it is the distance of my eye, because this is the origin of this opening angle, and this is exactly 7 meters. The next thing I need to do is I need to measure the width of this tree. And if you are at home, in your home office, and if you don't have a tree at hand, you can determine any width. You can even do it in your office. You can use a wall or any other target object that has a defined width. Let me just measure the width of this tree at the position where I have the yellow band. Again, here I use a caliper because I'm not interested in a precise measurement of a diameter. I like to measure the width of this tree exactly from the side where I aim at the tree. And this is 24 centimeters. So we have a distance of 7 meters and a width of this tree of 24 centimeters. We can use this now to calculate the counting factor of your own thumb by applying a quite simple formula. If you like to learn more about the background of this formula, please visit our AWF wiki for further information about the theory of Relascope sampling or Bitterlich sampling. The formula that I need to apply is 50 times the distance, 50 times the diameter, sorry, divided by the distance, and take this to the power of 2. It is important that you enter both values in the same units, centimeters or meters. So I will calculate in meters, and that means I need to calculate 50 times 0.24, which is the diameter of this tree in meters, and I need to divide this by 7, which is the distance, and I need to square this result to the power of 2. So for me, my personal counting factor is 2.93. This is a personal constant, so it depends on the length of your arm and the width of your thumb. But once you have calculated your own counting factor, you can do an angle count sample simply by using your thumb. So I can do exactly the same thing that I have done with the dendrometer before. I turn around and I count all the trees that appear bigger as my thumb. Those that exactly cover my thumb I will count as half trees, and those that are smaller are out trees. I will not count them. At the end, I need to multiply the number of trees that I have counted with my personal counting factor of 2.9. Please try this in your own forest and determine the own counting factor of your sump and remember this personal constant for your future life. You already learned if you also have information about the dominant height of the trees, you can even directly get a prediction of the stand volume at the position that you are standing. Thank you for watching so far and see you in one of our next tutorials.